It's a new year 2020 vision. You know, we had a preacher say 2020. Well, God has his 2020 vision. If we could just, you know, we're going to have everyone speak today. If we could just have all of us pray before we begin. So let's all just come together in prayer. Father God, I pray to you, Lord, right now. I pray that your will be, that your presence be here, that your presence be among us, Lord, that we'll be filled with the Holy Spirit. And whatever we do and everything we do, that we'll use it to glorify your holy name, Jesus, and that we will be in accordance with your will, and it'll be a fulfilling time. Thank you. Amen.
Thank you.
Teenager, this was my best friend. It was a different guitar, but it was my best friend. That's before I met Jesus. And then Jesus became my best friend.
Praise God.
Amen. Hallelujah. Here's a song by Tim Timmons. I guess a lot of children sing this one. No, it's not. Yes, Jesus loves me. The same great love that broke the dawn, same great peace that calmed the sea. Hallelujah, living in me.
What if I believe?
flowing through me. What I believe in your power, I believe in you. What I believe, Christ in me. Something that was keeping heaven from coming in was ripped apart. Hallelujah. Through our worship, through our faith, through our whatever, we can rip that veil and tear those things, demonic spirits that have prevented the glory to come in. Amen. Praise God. Considered as kind of a Jamaican beat a little bit. Because of him, because of his blood. There's a place where the street shines of the glory of the Lamb. There's a way we can go there. joy everlasting. There is gladness, there is peace, there is wine overflowing. There's a wedding, there's a feast, because of your love, because of your blood. Oh, all our sins are washed away, and we may live forever. And now we have this hope because of you. Oh, we'll see you day to day, and we will.
His light that lights us up.
You know this one. Eagle's Wings. So like I do a few words now. There is no one else to satisfy. My soul belongs to you, like the deer fighting for love. And now I wait for you. Take me to your courts of glory. Oh, Father, Lord, give me strength to help my stand in this dry and weary land. How we need the river, how we need the rain, living water flow through us again. We pray, shower down your glory, shower down your grace. Let your holy presence fill this place. And deep calls unto deep. Lord, we seek to know glory. For there is only you, and our hearts cry out, Father. And now, Lord Jesus, come. May your love and grace restore us and breathe upon me, Lord. Let your mercies be brand new. Let the whole earth worship you. And how we need the river, how we need the rain. Living water flows through us again. We pray, shower down the glory, shower down your grace. Let your holy presence fill this place. Jesus, free us and your worship in spirit and truth. And heal us, reveal us your power. Let your holy presence fill this place. Love and grace restore us. Oh. His mercies be brand new. Let the whole earth worship you. Oh, how we need your cover. How we need your rain. Living water flow to us again. We pray, shower down your glory. Shower down your grace. Let your holy presence fill this place. Let your holy presence fill this place.
Who feels God's anointing here, his presence here tonight? That was amazing. Very truly anointed. I think next one was Sandy. Sandy? Is it a song? Let them get ready. There's nothing I love more than being in the Spirit. So if you feel, stand up, sitting, standing, stretch out your hands, do that. Life's true. Testimony. It was about a week ago. This is my personal testimony. About a week ago, I had a really bad day. I came back to my room, feeling all burned out, all tired, all about what's going on in my life, and things didn't seem to be working out. It was in that moment. I just threw myself on my bed and I just began to pray. And I actually was more like complaining to God, not really praying. I was more complaining to Him. Things aren't working out. I just got an argument with my brother and this. And then I just said, God, you promised to give me the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And He filled me up. So immediately I began to speak, not in tongues, but in English. In English and Russian too. And He just filled me up. And I was frightened because I could not control my words. It's like I let the Spirit flow and it just... And the first thing he said was that I bind every evil spirit that contradicts God and is trying to destroy my life. And I never pray like this. Was the first, it just came out like this. I bind every evil spirit that's trying to destroy my life, because the enemy, he doesn't want us to have a relationship with God. He doesn't want us to put God first. He doesn't want us to put God's kingdom first. God wants to give us the spiritual gifts. That's what He showed me. He says, I want you to walk in the spiritual gifts. And ever since then, I've been just calling people nonstop. I called a friend and I started speaking to him. He's from North Carolina. And out of just the words came out. It says, God wants you to prophesy. I'm like amazed. God, it's like, Andre, you have no idea. I didn't really mean to say it. Like, God just spoke through me. And I believe this year, are we almost ready? I believe this year, 2020, and I heard a preacher speak, 2020 vision, God's going to do wonderful things this year, and I really do believe it. In the church, in the churches, He's cleaning out His churches, and He's going to clean out, I believe, and bring revival to America, I really do. I know, Sandy.
Try one to
rack. There we go.
Gotta turn it on.
In Psalm 119:25, it says, my soul cleaves
to the dust, revive me according to your word. And in other versions, different versions, it uses words like quicken and give me life. But revive brings about a beautiful word picture. Revive means making alive and giving more life. So revive me in your ways, Lord, according to your word. Revive me according to your loving kindness, that I may see your word. Revive us, O Lord.
Thank you. Down this undiscovered hall, I run my hand Red, red.
I got
got this one song. It's in Russian, but I'm going to try to translate it and sing it in English as well. You have to bear with me a little on the English. The chorus goes the same words over and over, Moi Bog Sa Mnoy, which means my God is with me.
Я поставлю дом свой на скале спасения. Буду строить через я во Христе на Божьем откровенья. И огонь испарит вода и потопит, все бури пройдут стороной, потому что на камне живой я стою, потому
translation yesterday, or today actually. So it came out how it came out in English. Praise God. Our God's always with us, amen.
Amen.
We got Young.
Gary?
I don't know. Was somebody able to go get Gary? Maybe he's practicing.
He's practicing?
Yeah, it's possible. With Ben? Well, he's got to come here now.
The first song is Open the Door. Open the door of heaven. Open the door of heaven and look at us, God. Our worship for you doesn't end in opening the door, the windows of heaven. And watch us, Lord. Watch us. We are here to praise you. That's our purpose, to be in this earth, to praise you endlessly. And that's what we're going to do in the heaven. It's in Korean.
Yeah.
돌보소서 이곳에 인재 이곳에 인재하소서 주님을 기다립니다 기도의 향기가 하늘에 Fresh oil in my heart, there's a cry, insatiable desire. I want more of your fresh oil. You give more of your power. Thank you.
I want more, I want more of your pressure. You give more of your power. I want more of your pressure. You give more of your power. I long to see your power flow until the whole world calls my Jesus the Lord. I want more, I want more of your pressure. You give more of your power. I long to see your power flow until the whole world calls my Jesus the Lord. Fill my life with Holy Spirit.
It was amazing. It was what do we got? Are you ready?
Get ready.
Well,
born ready.
Right. Then went.
Do you have somebody that you want to put in front of me? That's fine. We got somebody else ready.
If you're ready, come on, all right, let's do it.
Benny!
Okay.
I get this one verse that I like to read from Isaiah. It says, "For I am about." Mike, there we go. "For I am about to do something new. See, I have already begun. Do you not see it? I'll make a pathway through the wilderness. I'll create rivers in the dry wasteland." Was actually Bible. That was the Bible verse that they had. The verse of the day, it was not too long ago. A new version. They have they had this verse, you know, and like I was saying, the 2020 year. You know, I believe God's going to do something this year. I believe He's going to do something with the youth in America. We pray that He's going to pour out His Spirit. It says that I'll pour out a spirit, your sons will see visions, the old men will dream dreams, and your sons and daughters, they'll prophesy. It says this, and it's amazing how many people I've been calling, and they have the same situation, especially young people too, but everybody, but I'm saying the young people that didn't care for God, you know, God's just outpouring gifts on them. He's making them prophesy. I have another situation. I was in Ohio for New Year's, and And there was another guy, he just came back from Bible school, young man, and he's with the Lord, and God just gave him a gift. He gave him a gift to prophesy. I said, this is amazing, you know. I didn't know.
Take your time.
So I had a friend I was calling. I do a youth ministry with the young people, and he had this gift. He said, I already told him a month ago, why don't you come preach at my church? It's all God's youth. But I say it's my youth. We have a bunch of young people there, 10 to 15, and God just confirmed. I started sharing him the testimony that I was, you know, God, the Holy Spirit just overtook me, and I began to speak words that I would never think I would speak. And he said, you know, I've had this gift already for 7 months. You know, he's another young guy. And God just gave me this gift. And I wanted to, this is a confirmation for me, because I wanted to come to your church. And I wanted to preach about spiritual gifts. Mm-hmm. Now that you're calling, this is such a confirmation. You have no idea. You know, we may not always see it, but God's always working. He's always moving.
Amen.
Thanks, Andy. Tough. Snack cooking. No, it's not cooking.
There it is.
It wasn't cooking a second ago.
All right, great. Thanks.
There are days I've taken more than I can give. There are choices that I've made that I wouldn't make again. I had my share of laughter, tears in troubled times, and this has been the story of my life. I have won, I have lost. I got it right sometimes, but sometimes I did not. Life's been a journey. I've seen joy, I've seen regret. Oh, and you have been my guide through all of it. You were there when it all came down around me. I was blinded by my fear and struggled to believe. But in those unclear moments, you were the one keeping me strong. And this is how my story's always gone. I've won, I've lost. I got it right sometimes, but sometimes I did not. Life's been a journey. I've seen joy, I've seen regret. Oh, and you have been my guide through all of it. You have been my guide through all of it. And this is who you are, more constant than the stars up in the sky. All these years of my life, I look back and I see you. Right now I still do, and I'm always going to. I have won, I have lost. I got it right sometimes, but sometimes I did not. Life's been a journey. I've seen joy, I've seen regret. Oh, you have been my guide through all of it. You have been my guide through all of it. You have been my guide through all of it. This child that you deliver
It's as simple as smelling a rose. To stop and listen before the kissing, when you do, you will be brand new. So come now, friend, to the end of the pretend, and you will know who is your foe. Look to me, says he, who was and is and will be, for we have today not to dwindle away, but to take time and pray. When day becomes night, you will have won the fight, only to wake in the light.
Greg, that's it.
Oh, come on, Greg.
Also, Michelle, is it a song or song?
Three songs.
Okay. So while Michelle gets ready, just gonna share. There was not. So many months ago in my life, I was going through a wilderness, you know, and there's some people, sometimes we have this question, where is where is God? I was following him and something just didn't go right, you know? I seem to be doing things right, but maybe I can't hear his voice, or maybe he's not answering my prayer. And you know, and God says, I'm taking you through the wilderness. When he liberated Israel from Egypt, he took them through the wilderness. And in that place, they had to learn to trust God all the more. No matter what, in your life, whatever wilderness there may be, and I'm reminded by this, the wilderness is the place of purification. God, he purifies, and he continues to work in us there. And then, are we going to grumble and complain, or are we going to make it to the promised land, where God has promised us? So, I just leave with that.
Thank you.
Karina Milano.
Hi, guys.
We are Christians.
have a mic up here.
He's mighty. giver of salvation, by his stripes I am healed. My God is awesome, today I am forgiven, his grace is why I'm living, praise his holy name.
Oh, Sabaoth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You called us to be separated, Lord. You called us to be holy. You called us to be separated from the nations. You called us to be holy and walk in holiness before you, Lord God. Oh, Rabba Shalala, Rabba Hamahashia. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are holy, God. You are holy, God. Hallelujah. 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 Holy, holy, God.
I didn't really prepare anything to say. And when I walked in, I was late, and you were talking about God giving you words to speak. Just words flowing, and all you would do is speak them out. Is that correct? Okay. You see, when we preach the Lord Jesus Christ, that is the spirit of prophecy. The testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. So when he gives you words that seem to come out of nowhere, but we know where they're coming from, and you speak those words, amazing things happen. Every single one of you here think that prophets are these mystic people that get this strange gift and they speak it out and stuff happens. And sometimes it doesn't. But let me tell you something. That is something I experienced this week that changed me. And I want to talk about that a little bit because I hope it's going to touch everyone here at least a little bit. A lot of people here tonight are from the healing rooms. And at the healing rooms, we have people come in and we pray for them. And we don't know what to say. We don't know what is going to happen. And it all happens as we go along. And what God wants us to do is simply listen to Him. Amen. And speak out what He gives us. Now the problem with that is, sometimes we're scared to even go in front of a group of people and say anything.
Glory.
Some people want to sit back and just enjoy things. But let me tell you something. If you don't speak out what's in your heart, there are a lot of things that will not be accomplished.
Yes.
When the Lord first gave me the gift of prophecy, I had a very dear friend who talked to me, and I was young in the Lord, so he was sort of my best buddy that I could confide in and say, tell him some things and how I felt. And one of the things that I felt was when the Lord gave me something, I was hesitant to speak it out.
Help us, Lord.
Hesitant to speak it out. And there's one thing that he said that convinced me not to do that anymore. He told me, when God wants to say something and you don't say it, you're going to rob somebody of a blessing.
That's right. That's right.
So don't you be so shy that you're going to be sitting there, God gives you something, and you don't bring it to the forefront.
Yes.
That is what happened this week, so surprised me. You were part of it. I hope you noticed what happened. You know. Okay. There's a Ken from the healing rooms encouraged one of his relatives to come to be prayed for. Do you know this one? Okay. And this just happened a few weeks ago. When did they come in? A couple of weeks ago did you come in?
About 2 months ago.
Okay. And we prayed for her, and the Lord gave me a word that I just felt I should say because I don't want to hold anything back anymore. And what she described to the situation was desperate. And what was going through my head was, we've had too many of these.
Yes, Lord.
What are we going to do now? We're going to say another polite prayer and see this person going out, and will she be healed or not? Lord, you got to do something. There's too much of this stuff happening. That's what was going through my head. So we started praying for her. The Lord words to say. Listen, first of all, we are supposed to be people who have compassion. But let me tell you something, when it comes to the enemy, you don't show him compassion.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
And when he masquerades like somebody who's asking for compassion, you don't give it either when you know it's him.
Come on.
Amen.
So when you pray for people, like this lady that was before us, I felt that I was supposed to really step up and blast this thing. And the Lord gave me the following words, and she had a problem with the tumor. And I got mad at the devil, and I command the blood supply to this tumor to cease, and for the tumor to shrivel and die.
Glory to God.
Amen.
And then I tacked something on that I never say. I said, when you, after tonight, you go back to your doctor and you tell him you want another test done. You want another test done. And if they don't want to do it, be persistent. And if that doesn't work, tell them you want a second opinion. And Ken walks into the healing room Thursday night. It was Thursday night, right? And he taps me on the shoulder, and I'm ready to set up a computer to put the healing room preaching on live, and I really didn't have much time to do that. So I sort of resented when he wanted my attention because I didn't know whether I had enough time to set it up. So I almost brushed him off. And he says, Fred, I got to tell you something. Yeah. He said, I believe it was his cousin, came in for prayer. She went back to the doctor, he said. She had, and the doctor said that they didn't want to do the test, but she was persistent. She insisted on it, and finally told them that she opinion, and they ran the test again, and the doctor said the very words that you said when you prayed. The blood supply of the tumor was cut off, the tumor shrank and died. There's no more cancer. That is God. When you speak the words that seem to come out of nowhere, I'm not the only one that has this gift. He's in every single one of you. You can do it too. Just listen and don't let the enemy put fear on you so you don't speak out.
Yes, Lord.
He wants to do so much through his church. He wants to do so much through every single one of you. Don't pass it by. Don't let him pass by and not act on what you feel in your heart, what you feel in your gut. Look, ladies, I'm not a female, but I know that mothers know when there's something wrong with their kids, when something is going on. Huh. Where do you think that's coming from? That's God. God letting you know. So when you feel that stuff turning inside of you, when you just know that you know that you know, do something about it. Speak it out.
Yes, faith without words.
Because those words that you speak out, they're going to have power.
Yes.
My life got changed by doing what I did that night. Now, I don't know, I forgot what Young prayed, but I remember the words I said. We both prayed for this lady.
Yes.
And she got touched marvelously. I just don't want to sit around and just enjoy everything. There's work to be done. There's work to be done. And he needs you. He needs every single one of you. You're going to see the power flow.
Amen.
And he's going to be glorified through that.
Amen.
Don't take the glory. If he wants to lift you up, he will lift you up. Just trust him and do what he asks you to do. Amen.
Amen.
Have a word.
Yes.
Spanish people praising him. She said she's Spanish. She said you forgot Spanish, so.
So she said all the nations of
America. Musta. Musta.
Praise God. Praise God. Alabara Dios.
Slava Bogu.
Slava
Bogu.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Thank you for that word, Fred. That's a right on time word. Well, as you all know, I love to sing, play my percussion instruments, but I've been battling with this cold for 3 weeks already, and it's kind of draining my energy and starting to get better after I had gotten put on antibiotics and went for a few days. Kind of okay. Now it seems to be coming back again. My chest is hurting, my throat is hurting. Hasn't gotten to my ears. I keep them, try to keep them covered. But keep me in prayer. In Jesus' name for healing. Thanks again for that word, Fred. It's true what he's saying, and I know that's the Lord speaking through him. Because it's our responsibility to do that, to speak what God puts on our heart, because we could be robbing somebody of a blessing, and it's better to be on God's good side. Everybody says, oh, he's a good guy, he doesn't have a bad side. Okay, find out on your own what he does, how he disciplines his people. But I just want to say congratulations to my son Eric Roman and his new wife Cassie. They got married on December 11th. They made it right with God, and I am so proud of them. And I just, they're babes in Christ as far as, you know, really getting on God's right side, being right with God, and as far as truly learning how to walk with Christ. So because of that, I am going to share that word and the encouraging and confirming word that Fred brought through today is confirmation that I do need to share this. Forgive me for running out of breath, but that's what's happening right now in my chest. What I feel the Lord putting on my heart is two different scriptures. And one of my favorites is in 1 Corinthians 13. We all know, we call that the chapter of love. It's godly love. There's no flesh in it. It's spiritual, and it's how we should live our lives as born-again believers. This is how, as you're Svetlana, right? I love that name in Russian. And this is how, I was just talking to my daughter-in-law about this in the car on the way here. And she made a statement, and I says, well, you know, I don't hate anything that God creates. God created all the nations, all the creeds, all the tongues, all nationalities.
Amen.
For his divine purposes. Now, the minute the enemy gets in there, throws a monkey wrench in there, guess what we have? We have riots,
We have prejudice, we have murders, and all of this and all of that, and gossip and envy and destruction. You know, it's just all out of order. But when we have God, and this is another thing I told them both, if you invite God into your marriage and into every relationship, whether it's friendship or whatever the case may be, you better believe it's going to be blessed of God. But if you push him to the curb, as they say, and you don't give him any place in that relationship, you're going to have a lot of problems. It's like you're bucking heads. You're going to be bucking heads. Why buck heads? We're not getting any younger, folks. Let's let this word of God transform us by the renewing of our mind, by the washing of the water of the word of truth, so that we can start thinking like God, speaking like God, meditating on this word is a cleansing thing. And when you're in God's presence, you never leave out the same. We're not going to be perfect as he is until we're with him, but at least we won't be where we were before. You'll be, every time you leave his presence, you'll be a lot better than you were before. You know what I mean? So let me read this, and I'm not going to rush through it, like zoom through it so that nothing can stick. This is how we meditate on his word. Okay? Okay, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, the praises of charity. Charity means love. Okay, for those that don't know, remember, there's all levels of believers in this building. Okay, so let's just be patient with those that are just coming to the Lord or just really, truly wanting to know more about him. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels and have not love or charity, I am become as a sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith, so that I could remove mountains and have not love, charity, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned and have not love or charity, it profiteth me nothing. Charity suffereth long and is kind. Charity giveth not, charity envieth not. That means it doesn't want what others have. Okay? Charity vaunteth not itself. Okay? It is not puffed up. It's not proud. It's humble. It does not have behave itself unseemly. It doesn't seek her own. It's not easily provoked. It thinks no evil. Charity doesn't rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in truth. Charity bears all things. Charity believes all things. Charity hopes all things. Charity endures all things. Charity never fails, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is part shall be done away with. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know even as I also am known. And now abideth faith, hope, and charity, or love. These three, but the greatest of these is love, charity. And God is love, okay? And then the other word that God put on my heart was in Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 5. Be ye therefore followers of God as dear children, and walk in love as Christ also has loved us and has given himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet-smelling savor. Okay? And it goes on to say a bunch of other things that may not sound nice to people, but it's the word. So we're going to go with it. But fornication and all uncleanness and covetousness, let it not be once named among you, as becometh saints. Neither filthiness, nor foolish talking, nor jesting, which are not convenient, but rather giving of thanks. For this ye know, that no whoremonger, nor or unclean person, nor covetous man, who is an idolater, hath any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Let no man deceive you with vain words, for because of these things cometh the wrath of God upon the children of disobedience. Be not ye therefore partakers with them, for ye were sometimes darkness, but now ye are light in the Lord. Walk as children of light, for the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth, proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. And let us remember that it is our duty to be pleasing to the Lord. And have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. For it is a shame even to speak of those things which are done of them in secret. But all things that are reproved are made manifest by the light. For whatsoever does make manifest is light. God is light. Wherefore he saith, awake thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give you light. See then that ye walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. Wherefore, be ye not unwise, but be understanding. But understanding what the will of the Lord is, and be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled with the Spirit, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual tongues and singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Be encouraged in the Lord and encourage your brethren in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Stand up and pray together. And we'll also pray is Pastor Terry here?
I don't know.
You'll be able to pray. Well, let me pray a bit. You come up, you pray a bit and close. And also won't forget to pray. Pastor Sherry, if you could also pray, don't forget to pray for Naomi, you said you had.
Oh, yes. Yes, thank you.
Father God, we come to you, Lord, now in prayer.
Yes.
Oh, Heavenly Father, we just ask that you will walk away from this place, Lord, that you will fill us up in all our deeds and all of what we do and say, that we'll just glorify your name. You, God, will just leave the world. Fully give our lives to you, Lord, that we'll fully give our lives to you and put you first. Put you before any other thing. Put your kingdom first and you, God, first. Because you say if we put you first, then everything else will be added unto you. So, God, let us fully sanctify, fully dedicate ourselves to you, Jesus, so we can see your kingdom goes. So it'll be your will, not my will, but your will in my life. Pray.
Pray also for Sister Suwan, who was here last time. She's in Cambodia now. 10 days trip, and she was asking to pray for her. Yeah. Preaching in these areas. On mission trip.
Sister
Anne. Yeah.
Can you go? Do you want me to pray for her?
Our Father in heaven, we want to thank you and praise you for each day. Man and woman in this house, and children, Lord God. Father, we ask you to touch our bodies at this time. Let the power of the Lord be sovereign and move across this audience here, Lord God, and move across to those who are not here, who need your healing anointing in their body. Lord, we want to thank you that Jesus paid the price for our bodies to be made whole, for our minds to be made whole, and for our lives to be complete. And we just give you that glory and honor and that praise, Father God. Lord, we just extend our hands toward each and every person here in your name and for your glory. Just power and Father God come upon them and through them in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Lord, for those who are here and left early, Lord God, I also lift them up and ask you, Lord, to give them peace of mind and healing also in their bodies. And now, Father God, we thank you for the blessing upon the meal that's provided.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, bless that food, Father God, that we may give you the glory and the honor and praise again. Can you say that lady's name again?
Suwan.
Suwan.
She is a Korean lady. There is a Korean whole group on the mission.
Pastor Suwan.
Suwan, is she still here in Cambodia?
Cambodia.
She's in Cambodia. Cambodia, how you pronounce it.
Okay, what's her immediate need?
They are there for 10 days. They arrived yesterday and she is in need.
Safety?
For safety, for say just there
the gospel.
The gospel to people, so people would be accepting, be open.
Lord God, we thank you for Suwan. I thank you, Lord God, for giving her safety in Cambodia, where she's at right now.
Yes.
Lord, I bless her feet, and wherever she walks, Lord God, you said how lovely are the mountains on the feet of those who bring good news. Lord, I thank you that she's bringing good news right now. And Father, let the power of God be surround her with your angels, Lord. And show her miracles and signs and wonders to give to the people for the name of your glory. For the name of your glory, Father God. We praise you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, that these miracles are coming forth and they will be proclaimed, that your name will be magnified and glorified. Bring some children, Lord. Bring lots of children to this woman and help them, Lord God, to be revived. Someone said that word revived today, right? You said that we're revived. God's turn you around. Turn them around, Father God. And then revival in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Father, I thank you for the vision of this house. I thank you for the vision of this house, Lord God, that they are looking for you to move mightily in 2020. And that you will move mightily in 2020. I thank you, Lord God, you're raising up young men and young women, youth, to carry the baton and to do it with vigor in the Holy Spirit. Thank you. And let them be honorable, Father God, in all ways, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Can you shut this thing off?
If you don't shut it off, I won't be quiet.